All right, here we go. Mega Man X 3. Which, some, if anyone who's played all the original Mega Man X games, this may be your personal favorite. It's got a lot of shit packed in here. So, game starts out with a little cutscene. Dr. Doppler has apparently neutralized the Mavericks using a Neuro computer. He's been able to suppress any abnormal behavior in the Reploids and prevent them from going berserk. But guess what happens? Many of the most advanced Reploids have gathered near their new mentor and founded Doppler Town, a perfect utopian community. It's like one of them crazy gated communities, only with robots. So with Doppler guiding them, the world seemed ready to enter a new golden age. But as you can tell by the ominous fucking March of the Empire music, it doesn't end well. After a few months of complete total darkness, summarized by this complete total darkness, the Mavericks, who were supposed to have been neutralized by the Neuro computer, suddenly appeared and began to riot. Oh no! Who knows? Who thought that was ever gonna happen? Maverick Hunter headquarters, all the intelligence indicated that Dr. Doppler was the mastermind behind the invasion. What a douchebag. He just saved the world and then backstabbed all of us. Why would you go through that much effort? So now X and Zero have to destroy the invading Mavericks and bring Doppler to justice. Not like Dr. Wily in a sense. Oh, pretty badass. Cool ass art. Dispatching. Here's the thing. You have X, you have Zero, and you're gonna get to play both of them if you wanted to. A few hours later, emergency contact was made by the headquarters of Maverick Hunter. What now? Busy. There's a bunch of rockets. Don't tase me, bro. This is the headquarters of Maverick Hunter. So, okay. We're under attack from the Doppler Force. Oh no! Apparently Doppler built a bunch of bees. All units return to base immediately and return fire. Now it's personal. If it wasn't personal for Mega Man X 2, where they literally formed, they were literally called themselves the X-Hunters. Now it's personal because we're fighting in our front yard. Hell, we're fighting in our living room is basically what happened. Which, this is actually a pretty big level for fucking a headquarters. It's like there's a whole lot of Maverick Hunters. It's usually just the two of them, Zero and X, and Zero keeps dying every game. So, like I did in the other games, I changed the controls, which is mandatory for this game. Put a shoot button on the right trigger, and put the dash and the jump on the X and A buttons, so that I can keep my thumb on those two buttons at all times without having to move them. Because dash jumping is extremely important. So right off the bat, you have this kick-ass starting theme, starting intro, awesome on all levels. Unless you're playing, there is a PlayStation version of this game, which I recommend never playing, because they destroyed all the music. You'd be better off playing that game on mute and just enjoying the sick-ass gameplay than you would listening to the music. They completely destroyed it. Why? I don't know. I guess they thought it was neat. You know what would be funny is if we just completely remixed all the music, but we made it like shitty fucking keyboard and bossa nova rather than 8-bit heavy metal. The kids will love it. They'll love it. So here we go. Mini boss time. Guy named Mac. Never trust a guy named Mac, apparently. I'm a PC and I'm a Mac. Are they making a little suggestion here? I'm not a member of Doppler's army. Why would you hire that guy in your army in the first place? Yep. We have a Destiny, all right. Now here comes Zero with a new Zero theme, which is totally not a ripoff of Guile's theme in any way possible. Which, I don't know, did this game come out before or after Street Fighter 2? I think it came out before, didn't it? Or after. Yeah. It kind of reminds me of a combination of Guile's theme and one of Zero's themes. I don't remember which one from the previous games. So now this is kind of bullshit right here. These giant fucking spikes coming, spike balls coming from the ceiling. Because what are you supposed to do? How are you supposed to dodge it? I don't know. I don't even give a shit because you play Zero for all of about 10 seconds. Yeah, that was a really good acquisition to your army, Dr. Doppler. Which, that's his best attack. If you couldn't tell, the Z-Saber attack at the end of his charge, it will kill anything in the game in one hit, except for bosses, which it will kill literally in two hits. So, pretty fucking good. Unfortunately, you can never ever use Zero against bosses, except for, I don't know, maybe one very rare case, and you can't acquire the Z-Saber for Mega Man X, but I don't remember how. I'm not going to do it. I don't feel like it. But I am going to do 100% gameplay by collecting all the power-ups, all the items, and this game is also kind of unique because it didn't just have, you know, the 8 health ups. It didn't have the 4 sub tanks. It didn't just have the 4 armor parts. It also had 4 riding armor configurations. Like the little mech armors, or the big mech armors, really. But it also had 4 chips that would upgrade your existing parts. So you can only take one at a time. Which sucks, because they're all awesome. But there was a way, there's a little secret area, sort of like the way that the Hadouken was hidden in Mega Man X1. And if you find it, you can get all 4 upgrades at once, which is awesome. So I will be doing that. If you don't know what I'm talking about, I'll show you later on in this game. So starting out, I gotta fight all of Dr. Doppler's, you know, Maverick bosses, apparently. And most of them are really good. We'll start Blizzard Buffalo. Now, this game functions in a fairly similar fashion to Mega Man X2, where you kill 2 bosses, and then, like, the lead Mavericks will come and try to assassinate you. So, you have to be prepared for that, and fight them if you want. Well, actually, no. You don't have to fight them if you want, because you have to fight them. You can't not fight them. They put them in a path where you need to beat them to progress. So, if they're there, you're kind of fucked. So that's why I'm going to be doing this game in a very specific path, at least for the beginning parts. I need to do this stage, which this would be... you're going to see a lot of these little mini-boss rooms like that that are just going to be completely empty for no reason. And the reason is because they put it there just in case you'd have to fight one of the Maverick bosses there. So yeah. Also, if I would have fallen down that pit that was just above that ladder, that would have led to another secret spot, which would be where you could fight Vile. Which, by the way, Vile in this game. Kind of a spoiler, but not really, because you're going to find out very shortly. So, it's not like something that comes up at the end game. Now, this stage is really annoying. Or this part is particularly annoying because there's enemies everywhere that are constantly respawning. They do a lot of damage. And I'm trying to do something very, very delicate on slippery slopes, and the game does not like to cooperate. Which is part of what makes this game so fucking hard. So I'm gonna destroy that thing. Which, I don't know if it helps, but in my mind it helps. So, because I did a stage first for a couple of reasons. One, Blizzard Buffalo, pretty easy. He's not so bad. Two, because you've played the other Mega Man games, you know that the first thing you want to do is you want to get the leg upgrade parts. And it's the same upgrade parts that were in Mega Man X2, which lets you do an air dash. But it also lets you do a vertical dash. So, I mean, Mega Man 6, you had the jetpack. So it's sort of like that, except really shitty. But, you know, I'll take it. Whatever works. And there's your demonstration. So now that I got that, I'm going to go back. I'm going to go get an E-tank or a sub-tank. They're the same thing, really, except one's rechargeable. Fuck, I'm having trouble with a slope. Slopes suck. Dude, look at the fucking ridiculous, like, as soon as I'm going to move over there, it's going to respawn. I'm going to slip out the fucking wall, and I just want to do this without dying. That's my primary goal. Which probably going to die against the boss anyway. What the fuck? I don't even know what hit me. I just got frozen in place for no reason. And I'm going to die. Unless I can find a health item or something. Well, that was a close one. Kill this guy. I just want to get the E-tank. That's all I want. There. But you need to get the jump to get that. So, that's why I had to backtrack a little bit. There's a high health on him, and I'm not going to be able to get it because the fucking ice is stupid. So now I got to be careful. You know, I don't want to. Just so I can fucking hit the checkpoint. Because that's another thing I just gained that's kind of ridiculous. Is, there are checkpoints, but they're not very friendly. Because the stages are like twice as long as any other X game so far. And the checkpoints aren't until like, I don't know, 3/4 of the way through the fucking stage, or if you get to the end right there. That's like your only... It's the only checkpoint that you can guarantee on. So, he's gonna kill me. I know he's gonna... Yeah. It's kind of hard to evade it. So now I'm going to do this on a full tank. Which even then, he's not that easy. You still have to have a lot of agility, which is why the leg upgrade parts help a lot. Because I'm going to do a lot of the things where you're jumping off the wall and just jumping over his head. And being able to do an air dash helps. Because you can do like a regular dash, jump, and that works. But if you're lazy, dashing in the air is easier. Doing a lot of this. Kind of guerrilla warfare on his ass. He's not all that unpredictable. He's really only got the... He's only got 3 moves. He'll just charge at you. And he could shoot ice blocks. And occasionally he could shoot a giant laser, which does a fuck ton of damage. So, yeah. That's about all he's got. As long as you don't get hit by him, then you should be fine. And also, don't be standing on the wall when he hits the wall, because it will knock you on your ass. He doesn't like being fooled. He's not a very positive jokester. Oh, shot him in his ass. That was his ultimate weak spot, signified by him exploding, with one leg cocked up. He's got a little captain in him. So, what if I mention, what I have to do at the beginning of this game in a very specific way, as a precautionary measure. So, I didn't just do this stage first because it had an E-tank and the leg upgrade parts. I also did it because I need this weapon, because I'm going to be fighting a couple of bosses later, that if I don't have this weapon, then it negatively affects the end of the game. And you're going to see why in a little while. Which, the bosses that pop up that try to kill you and assassinate you, the Maverick Hunters, or not the Maverick Hunters, I don't know if they're X-Hunters. They're like Doppler's main minions. They appear at random. So they may appear immediately. They may appear, like, right at the end of the game. But they'll appear at some point. So I'm going to fight Tunnel Rhino. And I'm fighting Tunnel Rhino for the exact same reason that I went and fought the, what was it, Frost Buffalo? Blizzard Buffalo? is that I need his weapon to beat one of those bosses. So, it's a precautionary measure. I mean, there's also... There's a health tank, which is cool. I can get that now. That was a little side area, which I can't access right now because I don't have all the proper abilities. But also, the thing about this is to get all of the armor upgrade parts are really aggravating. Because you need to, at first you need to get the little dash jump, which I did already. And there was no requirements for that, just that, you know, I make a sick ass jump, which is sort of like the fucking the jumps in Mega Man X2 that required the charge up flame shot. Just really difficult jumps that could take you a while. I managed to do it on the first try, but yeah. So first you need to get the leg parts, and then after you get the leg parts, you need to get Tunnel Rhino's ability. I'm opening the door of my ass like a boss. I love doing that. So I hate this enemy, fucking drills. Cause you can't attack them, cause drills block everything. Do a fucking ridiculous amount of damage. Most of the enemies in this game do a ridiculous amount of damage. It pisses me off. They really went overboard with the difficulty, I feel. I will never recharge all my E-tanks at this rate. I can only have one, but I'm soon to get another one. Wait, maybe I already got it. I should have two. So, got for fallen boulders. They're everywhere. And that's another little side area that I can't access right now. But to get the next upgrade part, you have to get them all in a specific order because you need specific items to get them. The next item I need to get is the charge shot. And to get the charge shot, I need to get Tunnel Rhino's ability, as well as the leg parts, which I got. So I don't know if this enemy's supposed to do this, but this is how he fights. He just charges the wall like a dumbass, and you're just completely impotent while I shoot at him like this. I think if you attack him in a different strategy, he will start doing other shit. He uses claws to climb up on the wall and shoot at you or something, I don't know. But, not all that intimidating, if I do say so myself. He does take a lot of hits, though. He's a tough motherfucker. And so now he explodes like a boss, which, by the way, when you kill this guy, this isn't the halfway point yet. This isn't the checkpoint. So if you die, you have to fight this guy again. Which, really sucks. But another thing is, this ability, the little ice charge attack, which, that was bullshit, fucking drills, whatever. Kiss my ass. It's like every enemy has like a final death blow attack that's just fucking sick. Alright. Oh god, okay. So these guys, they're not so bad, but if you're gonna get hit by them, do not ever get hit by their laser attacks. They do a ridiculous amount of damage for no reason. And they just respawn right where they were, and he got hit by the residual ice block that was also still there, so. Ridiculous enemy placement. It's like Mega Man 3 on crack or something. I'm getting frustrated. I don't want to deal with all this. I just want to go. I gotta go fast. Why climb ladders and you can jump on walls? So if it wasn't enough that he shoots drills that block every attack, he shoots fucking little mini bombs too. Just to completely piss you off. So, I have this ice ability, which is not going to help. I'm going to have to fight this guy the old-fashioned way. And it's actually going to be very similar to the way I fought Frost Buffalo, except way faster. Because this room is a lot smaller, and he's way faster. He's also easy to confuse. But he has much more variety in his attacks. However, he focuses purely on this attack where he just rams the wall. I don't know if there's a coincidence there. Seems to be they're the only two guys that do that. None of the other guys really do this. A lot of the other, like, optional mini-bosses do, but it's really weird. So yeah, just fucking totally psyched him out. If you see him and he wants to try to sidestep you like that, that's all you gotta do. Just psych him out, make him think you're going the other way. And when he's flashing like that, he's invincible for like 7 seconds, something like that, an eternity. It's really weird. Which, another thing, you're gonna... He double sight, he triple, quadruple. Oh, he's completely lost his mind. He didn't even give a fuck. Tunnel Rhino. Such a boss. He actually sometimes is more aggravating if you use the special weakness on him, because he fucking just goes berserk. He starts using that invulnerability ability constantly.